In the last page, we are discussed about shapes, is it? Two-dimensional shapes. So in this, the student book itself, in this page, we are going to discuss about the 3D shapes and the names also, okay? This also you studied earlier. It is very easy for you. Just have a look here. So the first one, see, it seems like a circle, but it is not a circle. That's why see some shaded, some dark portions, everything you can see. It seems like a ball, is it? It is called a sphere. It is almost, it's a 3D of a circle, we can say. It's a sphere. See, this shape is called a sphere. It has how many faces? Only one face. Only one face we can see for a sphere, is it? It has one curved face. Does it have any edges or vertices? No edges and no vertices. Okay, it is called the sphere. Study the spelling also. Because in the higher classes, you need this. You need to study this right now itself. Again, coming to this 3D of a square. It is called a cube. It has how many faces? Six flat faces. See, 1, 2, 3. I can see 3 on the other side. Down 1, other 2 on these 2 sides. Okay. So, total we can see 6 flat faces. And all the faces are of same length. That is the speciality of a cube. Again, it has 12 edges and 8 vertices. In our first slide, I already discussed about this in detail. Okay. So, please go through that also. Coming to the next solid, which is this shape is called a cuboid. That is the three-dimensional shape of a rectangle. It is also having how many flat faces? Same like this, 6 flat faces. 1, 2, 3. I can see here on the other side. So you just visualize that. It's a 3D shape, you just visualize. On the other side also you can see 1, 2, 3. Again, same like a square. It has 12 edges, 8 vertices. Edges means these sides, is it? And 8 vertices. And opposite faces are same. These two are same. This and the back side are same. This and this are same. That is the difference between the cube and a cuboid. Okay. So the next one is a cylinder. Cylinder means how many faces you can see. See, one flat face up, one flat face down, and this middle one is a curved face. It's called a cylinder. It has 2 flat faces and 1 curved face. Is it? See, these two are flat up and down, and this middle portion is called the curved face. It has 2 curved edges and no vertices. See, this is one edge. Always the edge means it will differentiate between 2 faces. This is one face and this is another face. In between that, it comes the edges. So, how many edges you can see? One curved edge here and another curved edge here. That is called a cylinder. Then next one, look here, same like your birthday cap. What is the shape? It's a cone. Look here, what's a cone means? Here we can see one curved face and down it will be one flat face. Okay, so this shape is called a cone. It has one flat face and one curved face. Again, can you see any edges here? Yes, see this curved, here you can see the edge, is it? So one curved edge. And can you see any vertex, any corners? Yes, we can see one here. It is called the vertex. So one curved flat, it is having one flat face, one curved face, one curved edge, and one vertex. Is it clear? Then, so the next one, by looking at this shape, can you see what is it? It is a pyramid or a prism. We already explained. See, I cannot see any pointed things here. So we know it is a prism. So what prism is there? Look at this flat face. What is the shape of this flat face? It is a triangle. So it is called a triangular prism. It has 5 flat faces. One here, one the other side. 2, 3, 4. And here also we can, this opposite to this side also we can see another one. So it is 5 flat faces we can see. Again, the 2 opposite faces are triangle. Okay. The 2 opposite faces are triangle. And remaining 3 are rectangles. These 2 are triangles. See, this, the other side, and the down. All these 3 are rectangles. So it is called a triangular prism. So the next one is what? Again, it is a prism because flat faces. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here you can see 6 sides. So it will be a hexagonal prism. It has how many flat faces? 8 flat faces. See, from all these sides, one face will be there. So we know if it is having 8 sides means how many faces will be there? We know this 8 faces will sub here. In this case, it is a hexagonal prism, so 6 sides are there. So from all the 6 sides, we can see 6 flat faces. Then one will be here, another will be here. So whatever is the prism, what is the shape, plus 2 will be always the faces. So here we can see 8 flat faces. How many edges you can see? Edges means these joinings you can count. 18 edges will be there. And how many vertices will be there? Vertices means these corners. So double of this, is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Other side also 6. So total 12 vertices will be there. Again, these two opposite faces are hexagons. All rest, everything will be what? Rectangular. Okay? Is it clear for you? And the last one, it is what? From the shape itself, you can say it's a prism or a pyramid. It is pointed one. So we will say it is a pyramid. Okay? And see, this base, it is resting on this base. So depending on the shape of the base, we can name it. So see, 1, 2. Other side also 2 will be there. So we know it is a square pyramid. So see, it's a pyramid. The shape is not mentioned here, but it's a square pyramid. So how many faces you can see there? One down, and since 4 sides are there, from all the 4 sides, 1 face is coming. So 4 plus 1. 5 faces will be there. Again, how many edges? 8 edges. And how many vertices? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vertices will be there. Okay. The shape of the base is a square. So it is called a square pyramid. The remaining 4 shapes are triangles, and they meet at a single point at the top. It is why, that is why it is called a pyramid. Okay. So we already discussed about shapes and solids. 2-dimensional shapes and 3-dimensional shapes. Okay. This is student book page number 177. So all of you should study, you should by heart page 176 and 177. I'm not telling you to study today itself. You take your own time and study in 2-3 days. Okay. And after studying this, you do the homework in the workbook. I'll give you the page. You do that in the homework, as you can do homework in the workbook. Which page? Homework is workbook page 130 and 131. Okay. I will suggest you to, after studying, after finish studying, you go and do this workbook homeworks. Okay. And if you have any doubts, actually there is no chance for doubts because you already studied about this. Rest everything you need to by heart the things only. But still, if you have any doubts, you please contact me over WhatsApp. Okay. Thank you so much. Take care.